Well, this is day 20 of my trip. I'm hoping to be covering 3,000 to 4,000 kilometres going from one side of Australia to the other, from west to east. I'm using rollerblades as well, so hopefully I can get some good mileage in. At the moment I'm doing 50 k's a day, which is not bad going, but at the moment I'm on dirt roads, which is slowing me down a bit. I've got a 200 kilometre stretch from here to Balladonia before I get back onto the bitumen. When I get onto bitumen, I go across the Nullarbor and then head east. At the moment, I'm heading towards an old abandoned cattle station where hopefully I'm going to spend the night.
Well, this is the inside of the homestead. See, people can stay here whenever they want when they're passing. I've just given the place a bit of a sweep out. I have to share it though. I'm sharing it with some birds which are in the ceiling, and I'm also sharing it with a spider.
Follow.
I think it's a wolf spider.
Follow the sun.
That's a big
which
spider.
Way the wind blows. When this day is done, set your intentions, dream with care. Tomorrow's a new day for everyone. A brand new moon, a brand new sun.
So it's taken me just over a month to get here. I've knocked up 1400 kilometres so far, well, almost. I'm now at the Great Australian Bight. The air highway which I'm on at the moment is running parallel with the coastline. It will do that for probably the next 160 kilometres. Actually, my next stop is 160 kilometres away, and that's the Nullarbor Roadhouse. Well, I've just passed the sign saying I've only got 5 more kilometres to do before I hit the next roadhouse, which is a nice sign to see after walking for 5 days. My wheels seem to be okay at the moment, mainly because I'm not carrying too much weight. I've only got about 2.5 litres of water left and one can of spaghetti. So this roadhouse has come at a good time because I need to pick up some more supplies. Well, I'm not having a very good day today. I've only done 25 kilometres, it's stinking hot. I just got a puncher and I went to repair the tube. I got a puncher outfit, but it's so hot that all the glue is evaporated. So I have no glue. And useless. But what I'm going to have to do is hide the trailer somewhere here in the bush, and hopefully a car will stop and give me a lift back to the last roadhouse where I just left this morning. Get some glue, repair the puncher, hitchhike back and start again. Oh no. Never mind.
Oh.
I've just walked in today. Ah, fuck it. Basically, all I'm trying to say is I'm suffering from dehydration at the moment. And I've got cramps in my hand, cramps in my leg. But luckily, I've managed to get to a park they buy, where some other campers are camping for the evening. So hopefully, after having a rest and getting in the shade, I should be okay. But on walking from here to the camper van, I passed out. I didn't realise how bad I was. But I know how it feels now. I definitely fainted. And as I say, all my hands are all cramped up and my legs are cramped. I'm taking dehydration salts now, and hopefully that'll help. These Australians... cramps! These Australians think I'm as mad as a hatter, I'm sure of it. Don't blame them.
Python, bruh. Python. It's a python.
You pick it up, then.
It's a python.
Oh,
it doesn't bite.
So this is only a python, is it?
Yeah.
If it's poison, isn't it? It'll just... Okay.
It's, if it's python, it stays still, see? Doesn't bite.
Well, it's Christmas Eve and I'm still on the road. I lost a bit of time after getting dehydrated, and it was quite a scary experience for me, really. You don't realise how quickly it comes over you. My whole body started to go into spasms and cramps, starting in my arms and my hands and then my legs. But the thing is, you get delirious and you don't want to drink. That's really what kills you. I had water with me.
I actually found a can of beer on the side of the road today. Can you believe it? It's a bit warm, but it's all right. So cheers and happy Christmas. There's a big heart beating on the big people in the big world.
Well, I'd say some days I don't really want to be doing this. It's absolutely pouring down the rain. But believe it or not, this morning it was 41 degrees, stinking hot. And then this afternoon it comes over and it's with pouring rain and gales. I had to pitch a tent in the rain as well, so all my tent's soaking wet, all my gear's wet. I'm absolutely soaked to the bone. You can hear it's pouring down outside, but at least it's cooler, so that's one good thing. But I'm going to try and light a fire now and cook some food, which is going to be easier said than done. In a big world, there's a big heart sign beating on the big people. Well, I'm 440 kilometres away from Sejuna. I'm halfway up a mountain range, and I've got Port Augusta in the distance, only 20 kilometres away, where I'm hoping to get to tomorrow morning. I thought, me being smart, I thought it'd be nice to spend a night up here, and I took a small dirt track to get here, but unfortunately it was so rough, with boulders, it was only a four-wheel drive track, that my wheel, unfortunately, collapsed on me. As you can see, it's totally buckled. I'm completely egg-shaped. So somehow this evening I'm going to try and fix it. I'm not quite sure how yet, but the last 2 days has been lovely, it's been quite cool, but before that it was stinking hot, and unfortunately it's only going to get hotter. Apparently February is the hottest month. It's now January, almost the end of January, so I got more heat to look forward to as I start going east. I'm more than halfway, so the trip's going very well, and hopefully, as I say, tomorrow I'll be in Port Augusta and have a one wheel fixed, I hope. Beating on the big people in the big world. Well, it's day 78, and I've done 2,500 kilometres to this point. I've been fighting into wind all day today, which is really hard going for me. I'm on my way to Wilcannia, which is not for another 3 days, but I'm just hoping the weather's going to change because it's stinking hot, and with this wind as well, and trying to walk into it is really hard going on me. Everything's wearing out, including my trousers, all falling apart. And this is another shirt, which is wearing out again. I'm going to have to probably buy another shirt when I get to Cobar. But my shoes are funny. Ow, my feet. They've got full-on holes in there. And I've padded them out with a bit of carpet, which I found on the side of the road. And same with this one, they're both buggered. So I've got to spend some money when I get to Cobar. New trousers, new shirt, new shoes. But I've only got 1600 k's to go, or 1600 k's, and I'll be on the east coast. And my speedo just registered, turned 3000 kilometres about a day ago, so I'm getting there slowly and having a great time, apart from today because I'm absolutely knackered. I've got to pitch my tent now and cook my tea, pasta again. I've caught another thunderstorm. I've had three of these in the last 3 days, and every time I've got soaking wet. Just sheltering for the time being underneath my tarpauling. I've been on the road now for 4 months, and I've probably only got about another month to go and I'll be in service paradise. But as I get closer to the east coast, there's more and more rain, and I seem to be getting drenched every day now. Not so much fun, but it's actually my birthday today, so it's a good way to spend a birthday underneath a tarpaulin. But it shouldn't last too long, I hope, maybe another 20 minutes, and then I can start walking again. The trouble is, everything gets wet, including my bedding, and then it's not very good in the evening to try to get the sleep on wet gear. Oh, yeah. The water's coming in as I speak. A few more steps, I'll be in Queensland. Well, I've never seen this before. These are a load of caterpillars. They're all following one caterpillar here in front. Just hope he knows where he's going. What an amazing sight, really. Well, I'm only a couple of days away now, maybe 3 to 4 days away from surface paradise. I only have one last challenge in front of me, which is the Great Divided Range. Hopefully I'll cross that by late this evening, stroke tomorrow morning, and then hopefully it's all downhill from there. Just on my way down now, off the top of the Great Divided Range. It's all downhill now for about 10k's. The only thing I'm worried about are the trucks, because they get pretty close to you. It's all hairpin bends. again! Well, 2 days from now I should be in surfers paradise. I'm not sure if I'm looking forward to it really, because it's going to be quite a lot to get used to after being out in the bush for such a long time. What I'm going to show you is what I've been eating for the last 5 months. Basically the same meal every evening. Consists of pasta, of one onion, and the home brand vegetable and steak, and a tin of spaghetti. And I just stew that all up together in my pot. And hey presto, within 20 minutes I've got a feed. I've picked a good spot to camp this evening. I'm not sure where I am, I'm probably on someone's land, but I don't think it'll be a problem camping here. But it's absolutely beautiful. Just in a valley with the mountains behind me, which I have to cross tomorrow. There's some more steep hills as well, so I think it's going to be hard work all the way to the East Coast.
Here's to now. Here's to now. Actually was thinking, said everything out loud, 'cause Epcot's he's good, awesome, that we don't worry about. Sitting on your doorstep waiting for you to come home or come out. Well, Apple seeds have a sound in mind that we don't care about. So here's to now. Here's to now.
Well, that should be my last hill. It should be all downhill now for Surfers Paradise. Thank goodness for that. Well, after 5 months on the road and 4,260 odd kilometres, I finally can see the sea, and I can see Surfers Paradise.
Here's to now. Been there, done that. Get the t-shirt there. Here's to now. Here's to now. Busboy's younger brother, when he drinks he talks too much. He seemed to know the thing, but at a quarter to three, well I could see he's a little bit touched. Actually was thinking, said everything out loud, 'cause Epcot seems scary awesome that we don't care about. Here's to now. Here's to now.